In the last lecture, we have solved some problems. Those problems we have used the triangle where you have the relation between del z 0, equilibrium constant, and reduction potential. And also we have seen that if you can stack all the standard reduction potential in the form of a series with respect to hydrogen electrode, then you also get a standard reduction potential series. And in that, if you have zero potential for the standard hydrogen electrode, then the top of that electrode would be top of that hydrogen electrode, let us say, if you have 0 as this H plus plus E half H 2, this is my 0 volt, and if you stack all the E 0 and this E 0 in the form of reduction potential, then you get a series, and that series you can judge if the metals or the reduction potential above 0 voltage, those are active, those are noble. And below 0 voltage, all the metal potential or the reduction potential of other reduction reactions will be considered as active. Now, this standard reduction potential says, one is whether metal is active or noble. That means, if the metal potential is above 0 voltage or below 0 voltage, if this is E 0 should be greater than 0 volt, and here it is E 0 should be less than 0 volt. Now, the second information what we get from standard reduction potential series, here the pure metal corrosion can be understood readily. For example, if you have copper and zinc, and if you have copper plus plus iron in contact with zinc, then zinc will come out plus plus and copper will deposit. So, this would be the reduction, this would be oxidation, and this is also true because we know that for this E 0 Zn plus 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 Zn to Zn, that means reduction potential is minus 0.761 volt. And in this case, E 0 Cu plus plus Cu equal to plus 0.34 volt. So, that means this is more than this, hence copper ion will deposit, zinc will corrode in the form of zinc ion. So, this information we can get for pure metal. Now, another case is, it provides a quick glimpse of which material will be more prone to corrosion. That means, in this case, zinc has the more proneness to corrosion, and in this case, copper has less proneness to corrosion because zinc has higher reduction potential or higher reduction ability. Now, there are few disadvantages, and mostly it gives you some theoretical basis that which one is noble, which one is active, because it based on thermodynamic data. Because del G, what this del E, what you are getting del E or E 0, what you are measuring with respect to standard hydrogen electrode in case of pure metal, because here the activity of the ionic species, all the activities will be 1. So, this is basically nothing but del G 0 by N F minus, because this relation, from this relation you are getting E 0. That means, del G 0 is purely a thermodynamic data. So, it is a thermodynamics, nothing about kinetics. So, you will not get any information about the rate of this process. You know that this is possible, but you cannot tell from this relation or from this data at what rate zinc will corrode and what rate copper will deposit. This information we cannot get. Now, coming to another point, let us say if you are considering the corrosion of an alloy, okay, let us say copper zinc alloy. So, in that case, or brass, in that case this information will not tell you what would be the situation here, whether copper will at all corrode or zinc will corrode. Those information we cannot get from this table. Now, another point is, this is a standard value. So, the temperature is 298 Kelvin. So, if you consider different temperature, then also you cannot get any information. Let us say I am giving one information, one example, zinc and iron. If you combine this, iron has E0 Fe plus plus Fe, its value is minus 0.44 volt. Now, if you combine this zinc and iron in HCl solution, then from this, it is pretty clear that this has higher reduction potential than zinc. So, iron should corrode more than zinc, but actually it would be reverse. If you club, if you galvanically couple iron and zinc in HCl solution. So, that case zinc corrosion would be less, iron corrosion would be more, but still from this information, from this data, at least we cannot say that the reverse is happening. So, that information we cannot get. So, these are, that means the practical corrosion information we cannot get out of this standard reduction potential series. But it has huge importance, that importance of whether importance of this has been found out in the problem where we have tried to see nickel, whether nickel would corrode in a deaerated H2O medium, where if you consider the last lecture problem, where we have seen that whether nickel, we have to find out theoretically whether nickel can corrode as nickel hydroxide in deaerated H2O, and with few information, for example, we know Ksp of NiOH2, we know that value, we know what are the reactions, redox reactions, so nickel, if nickel has to corrode, so it should go this way and another cathodic reaction would happen like this, and we know the pH of the solution. These were the problem, this was the problem, and we had to find out whether actually in this condition, set of conditions, nickel would corrode or not. And we have found out that nickel does not want to corrode in this condition, in this set of conditions, because we have found out that del G for this process would be positive. Okay, if it is positive, that means it is non-spontaneous. That means spontaneously this reaction would not happen. So, rather we can say that nickel cannot corrode in this set of conditions. Now, nickel hydroxide, now you see what are the products, what are the reactants, what are the products, or rather what are those species in this condition. This is one species, nickel. This is another species, because nickel hydroxide is forming. Initially it forms nickel oxide, nickel plus plus ion, and then nickel plus plus ion will react with H2O and forms NiOH2. Then also we have H plus, we have H2. So, these are the species. So, that means if we put all the species one by one, one is nickel, second is nickel plus plus, third is nickel hydroxide, fourth is H2O, fifth is H plus. So, these are the species in deaerated H2O. Now, let us say I have aerated medium. Now, if I have aerated medium, then I have to add another species, which is nothing but dissolved oxygen, O2. So, these are the species, those are available in the medium, if it is, this is in case. of aerated solution. So from this, in the problem we have just studied what would be the stability of different phases as a function of pH or potential. So that means we can, because when we try to find out del G, we had to find out what is the potential difference between the in the cell or between the reaction of reduction reaction and oxidation reaction. So that is one information we are getting, and with the help of stability, with the help of pH, with the help of solubility product of the precipitate or the phase that is forming on the nickel surface. So now if we try to see different reactions that can be possible combining these six species, let me note down all those reactions. One reaction is Ni++ plus 2E going to Ni. This reduction process can take place, or in other way around you can say that nickel is also going back and forming Ni++. That oxidation process can also take place. But I prefer to write it in terms of reduction, because that would help me to find out what would be my reduction potential. Now second reaction that is possible, Ni plus H2O, Ni plus H2O going to NiO plus 2H plus 2E, or I would prefer to write it in other way around. Let me write it in this way, because I have to write it in terms of reduction. So I can write it as Ni plus H2O. This is another reaction. Third reaction that are possible, Ni plus plus H2O going to NiO H2O going to NiOH whole 2 plus 2H plus. This is also possible. I am just writing all the possibilities. Now fourth is, again this NiO, which is the product of the reaction between nickel and H2O, in that case I can also form NiO can react with H2O and form NiOH whole 2. So this is also possible. So these four reactions that are possible, what I can frame, there are other reactions, but let me put all the simple reactions. These are the simple reactions. Now what are the other reactions? 5H plus E half H2, this is possible. Now sixth, now this is in case of deaerated media. Now if it is aerated, now you have another species O2. O2 can react with 4H plus 4E. It can go to 2H2O. 7, another reaction that is possible, H2O plus 4E going to 4OH minus. Now one more reaction that I can think of, 2H2O plus 2E going to H2 plus 2H minus. These eight reactions, simple reactions that I can think of considering all those six species. Now let me see what information, what thermodynamic information I can get from these reactions. Now one thermodynamic reaction is, I can find out what would be the mu of all those species. Mu of all those species, that means I can get mu of all species. Now let me note down all those mu's, because those are thermodynamic data. Now let me note down all those mu's first. First is, now when I try to find out mu, let me put it in such a manner that I'm having some data for mu zero, or the standard chemical potential for all the species, all the individual species. Now this I can find, I can have some data. I can have data mu 0, I can have data. Now then what else? I can have data for mu 0 H plus, mu 0 H2, mu 0 O2, mu 0 H2O, mu 0 OH minus. So these many mu's I can find it. Now convention is, when you consider a pure metal, this is considered to be 0. Again this is 0, again this is considered to be 0 again, because it's a pure gas. Now I can have this one, this is also assumed to be 0 joule per mole. Now I can have other data. Let me have other data. Ni plus plus is minus 46398 joule per mole. This is NiO. H2O is minus 236964.2 joule per mole. Then I have data for NiOH hole 2, minus 108.300 this is minus 47452694 joule per mole. Then I can have a data for NiO. NiO would be, just let me find out, you just find out, this is 51610 into 4.18, this is in calorie per mole, so it would be equal to minus, it would be equal to, let me, you just calculate, if you calculate it, let me see the calculator. Now this value is 51610 into 4.18 equal to minus 215729.8 joule per mole. So let me remove this part. So this is the value for this. Okay, now I have the value, the value that is remained is mu 0 OH minus. Mu 0 is minus data, let me also put that data. So the one data is missing, that is for mu 0 OH minus, that is minus 157.1 joule per mole. Now with these data sets, let me find out how many, what are the data I can make out of these standard data. From this, this is, you see that this is an electrochemical reaction, a reduction reaction. So I can find out what is E of for this reaction. E for this reaction, E zero rather, because I have considered all those standard state, and it is considered at 25 degree Celsius and unit pressure, 1 atmosphere pressure. Now for this, this is also an electrochemical reaction, and at the same time, you see the difference between this and this, you have considered here H plus ion. Now at the same time, you have two electrons. So that means it's electron accepting reaction or reduction reaction. At the same time, this reaction will depend on the concentration of H plus ion in the solution or in the aqueous medium, and this concentration of H plus ion in the aqueous medium or H2O can also be related to pH of the solution. That means this relation depends on potential as well as pH of the solution. Now this reaction, you see here, you don't have an electron associated with it. So rather it's a reaction which is not an electrochemical reaction. So now here it's basically involving, this reaction is involving Ni plus plus with H2O and forming NiOH whole 2 and H plus ion. So now again this reaction is pH dependent, but of course this would be definitely potential independent. Now again coming to this, this is, if you see this two different difference between 3 and 4, 3 is pH dependent, potential independent, but this is potential independent as well as pH independent. So pH of the solution as well as potential doesn't matter to have some data out of it. Now this is also electron involved as well as H plus. So this is pH as well as potential dependent. This is also, you see, H plus and electron. So this is also potential and pH dependent. This is another reaction where you have OH minus ion. So OH minus ion you can also reflect in terms of basicity, or in other way you can also put it as in terms of pH. So let's say pH 7, that means neutral solution. So in that case, POH, you can have pH, at the same time you can have POH. Okay, so POH, if it is 7, so this is 7, pH 7, so in that case it would be also 7. So neutral solution, pH POH is also 7, POH is 7. So if you know this, you can also know this from the solubility product of H2O. Now, or the dissociation constant for this H2O. Again, this one again is coming to be a potential as well as pH dependent. So you have few reactions. One reaction is one set of reactions. Now let me come to name all those reactions. Let me put in other way, let me put in such a way that we have three set of reactions. One is pH dependent, only pH dependent, rather let me put it only pH dependent. That means let's say this reaction, pH of the solution will decide whether nickel plus plus will go to form NiOH whole 2 with in the presence of H2 or not. This is only pH dependent. Now second set of reactions which are potential dependent. Which are potential dependent. And third set of reactions where you have pH as well as and potential dependent. So three sets, let's say, let me see, this one is definitely pH independent, only potential dependent. So let me put the number, this is, it falls under category of 2. Same thing, let me put it, this reaction here pH as well as potential, so it falls under category 3. Now this is falls under category 1 because it's only pH dependent. Now this one, now there is one set of reaction which is not pH or not potential dependent. So we have one set which is not a pH or potential dependent. So this is falling under category 4. Now again I can also put them in different categories. This is pH as well as potential, so category number 3. This is pH plus potential, category number 3. This is again also OH minus, I can put it in terms of pH. So this is also potential because it involves electron. So electron and pH, so this is also falling under category number 3. This is also falling under category number 3 because it also involves electron as well as OH minus ion, and OH minus ion you can put it in terms of H plus ion or pH. So now you see, whatever reactions that we have thought of that and those are happening in H2O solution in the presence of H plus and O2 dissolved oxygen, these many reaction for the timer we can think of, which leads to nickel ion plus nickel plus plus formation, NiO formation, NiOH O2 formation, or the other way around. So if we think these 8 reactions, can we put it on a diagram, okay, where you have 2 axes, one is potential, one is pH, because all those reactions except this reaction number 4, I can put them on this E versus pH diagram, because all the reactions, either they are potential dependent or pH dependent or pH or potential dependent. So when I put them in this diagram E versus pH, then I can specify that which section has Ni plus plus, which section I have Ni, which section I have H2O, which section I have H plus, which section I have NiO. All those species I can specify on this diagram. Now when I specify in this diagram, that time I construct a sort of, now when I put them, these reactions on this diagram, then I construct Pohr-Bex diagram, which this is known as Pohr-Bex diagram. Okay, so E versus pH diagram is nothing but the Pohr-Bex diagram, where it is a graphical representation of all those reactions that are happening in H2O in the presence of oxygen or H plus ion or both. So it is a basically a kind of stability of a metal and its corrosion products as a function of potential and pH, acidity or alkalinity of the aqueous solution. Now stability of a metal, because we have already seen in case of nickel corrosion that nickel forms NiOH2, and if it forms NiOH2, then we can also judge from this available data, that is the solubility product, pH of the medium, whether the further reaction from nickel to Ni plus plus would be happening or not, fine, and that is based on purely thermodynamic data. Now similar way, I can plot these reactions on this diagram, and also I will see that for a particular region of potential and pH, some phase or some species will have higher tendency to form, because I am using this tendency word because we are judging from thermodynamics. It cannot tell you whether actually that thing would happen or not, but it will definitely give you some idea or tendency that this phase would or this phase or species would form or not. Now let me plot these reactions on this diagram one by one. So first let me consider this reaction. This is pH and this is E, or E rather E0, since I would be using all the standard reduction potential, standard chemical potential. And if I use standard chemical potential, then this axis, if it is a potential dependent, would come as E0. Now, if you consider this reaction can be written in terms of, if you consider what would be the potential, I can write in the form of E equal to Ni plus plus Ni, that is a reduction potential would be E0 minus plus RT electron 2F ln Ni plus plus. Now, R is 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin, T is 298 Kelvin, because I have considered 25 degree Celsius, 298 Kelvin, and F is 96500, F is, this is T, this is R, which is universal gas constant, and this is F is equal to 96500 coulomb per gram equivalent. Now, if I put all those values here, then I would get E0 plus 0.059, roughly 0.059 log concentration of nickel plus plus. Now, if I take from, if I convert this, we would get this. Instead of ln, I am putting log, log, okay. And this is Ni plus plus Ni. Now, if I have the situation where nickel plus plus ion concentration is maintained at 1, this is 1 concentration, if the concentration is 1, then E, the potential for this reaction, when the concentration of Ni plus plus ion is 1 unit, so then I will get E Ni plus plus equal to E0, which is standard state, standard reduction potential for nickel. Now, how would we get standard reduction potential for nickel? Then again, I can have mu 0 Ni plus plus. Now, I know what is the value of mu 0 Ni plus plus and mu 0 Ni. Now, what would be my, from this I can calculate what would be my change in free energy, and since I am considering del G mu 0, so I will be considering del G 0, so it would be mu 0 this would be mu 0 mu 0 Ni minus mu 0 Ni plus plus, because this is my product, this is my reactant. So, if this is my product, this is my reactant, so let me put it in product, this is reactant, so mu 0 nickel, which is product, mu 0 Ni plus plus, which is reactant. Now, this would, you will get, let me put the value, plus 46398 joule per mole. Now, if I have this, what would be my potential? Potential, I can put it in this fashion, del G0 equal to minus NF E0, N is 2 here, so E0 would be del G0 by 2 into 96500 500, and there will be a minus sign, and it would be, if you find out this value, then it would come as 46398 divided by 2 divided by 96500. It is coming as 0.24 minus volt. So E0Ni++Ni, the potential is coming as minus 0.24 volt, whatever data we have. So now you see that you have found out E0 when the nickel ion concentration is 1. Now if you know the E0 with the thermodynamic data available here, then you have a relation which is nothing but E Ni++Ni equal to E0Ni++Ni if this one is 1, and if it is not 1, then this is my relation. This is my relation, and we have also found out value of E0Ni++Ni with the thermodynamic data what we have now on this board. Now this is an equation which relates potential to another standard potential, and this is, there is no pH term that is coming into this equation. And if you would like to plot this equation on this diagram, this should definitely be a horizontal line with respect to pH axis, because it is a pH independent reaction. Now let me plot this on this diagram. Let me put the diagram there so you can understand better, because whatever calculation I will be doing, that would be done on this side, and the final plot would be here. So this is my pH, this is my potential, and this potential is nothing but the reduction potential. Here I can write E aux rate. Now if I know this value minus 0.24, let me, this is 0.24, and this is the axis which is in volt. Now if I would like to plot this equation on this diagram, then it should be a line which is parallel to this axis. And if we would like to see the nickel ion concentration, if we change this nickel ion concentration to from 1 to 10 to the power minus 2, if I put 10 to the power minus 2 here, so then E of this Ni++Ni of that, for that reaction, if the concentration is not at unit activity, would reduce. Okay. If it reduces, that means, because if you check, if you change this, let me put, instead of 1, let me put 10 to the power minus 2. So I will put E Ni++Ni would be equal to E0, which is nothing but 0.24 minus, because since I have a minus 2 here, so it would be 0.059 into 2. If the concentration of nickel plus would be equal to this unit. So this is my minus 0.24, so potential will drop. If I increase it, if I again further decrease the concentration, again this potential will go down. So that means you see, as the concentration of nickel ion concentration is decreasing, your potential is also decreasing for the reaction compared to the standard reduction potential. So which means that nickel ion plus concentration, nickel region, if I reduce this, What does it mean? Means that it means the nickel ion concentration is decreasing, or if you consider the other way around, this way around, so nickel has the less tendency to go into the solution, because as the concentration is decreasing in the solution, let's say I have two beaker, one case concentration is 10 to the minus 6, nickel plus plus concentration is 10 to the power minus 6, where I have a nickel block and this concentration is this, and another case I have another nickel block in the water and I have nickel ion concentration is 10 to the power minus 1. So it's pretty clear that here concent corrosion is more, here corrosion is less. Or if I come from this to this, so I would rather increase the region. So if I come from this to this, what I am doing? I am basically trying to get into some situation where my corrosion tendency of nickel is going down, because I am going towards a lower concentration. So now if I place, let's say, Ni plus plus here and Ni, now this is for one concentration activity, or Ni plus plus equal to 1. Now if I put 10 to the power minus 2, this concentration 10 to the power minus 2, this line would go down, because here it will go down. So it will go down, that means this would be my axis point for the concentration for this. If I make it 10 to the power minus 6, then it would be here. This is nickel side. So what I am doing, I am extending nickel plus plus region and I am shrinking nickel. Now let me understand why the nickel is not on top, nickel plus plus is not on the bottom. Now coming to this same example, let's say I can measure up to the nickel concentration up to 10 to the power minus 6 unit. This can be molarity or this can be mole fraction. Now I can measure up to 10 to the power minus 6, and if the concentration of nickel ion is less than 10 to the power minus 6, if the nickel ion concentration is less than 10 to the minus 6, so that means that if the concentration of nickel ion goes below 10 to the minus 6, that means that I don't have any existence of nickel ion, because I cannot measure below 10 to the minus 6 unit of concentration. So if I cannot measure Ni plus plus, then what does it mean? That there is no existence of, virtually there is no existence of nickel plus plus, so only nickel will remain. Okay, if only nickel will remain, if the concentration is less than 10 to the minus 6, or when the measurement limit with the experimental setup what I have, in that situation, if the measurement limit is 10 to the minus 6, so if the concentration goes below 10 to the minus 6, I would say that there is no corrosion or there is no trace of Ni plus plus. But if I have this, so then I can say that there is a corrosion, or nickel can remain within the presence of, nickel can be present in equilibrium with Ni plus plus. And if it is 10 to the minus 5, then also I will say the corrosion tendency is increasing, or I would say that the amount of nickel ion concentration is increasing and nickel is highly getting corroded, or the nickel corrosion is substantial. Now like that way it will move off. Now why it is moving off? Let's say in one case my measurement limit is 10 to the minus 6, another case my measurement limit is 10 to the minus 5, another case measurement limit is 10 to the minus 4. So as you go from this to this, so you are basically lifting your line upwards, or you are since this is the measurement limit, so below this 10 to the minus 6, let's say this is my measurement limit, 10 to the minus 6. So below any line, I cannot have the existence of Ni++. This is the measurement limit, 10 to the minus 6. If I have the concentration 10 to the minus 7, then I cannot have any stress of nickel plus plus in this region, in this region. So if I don't have nickel plus plus in this region, then there must be nickel only. Now my measurement limit, I lift it to 10 to the minus 2. If I, my measurement limit is 10 to the minus 2, then below that concentration, I will only have Ni, because nickel ion concentration is not there, nickel ion is not there at all virtually, because I cannot measure below 10 to the minus 2. So that means that the lower part of this curve should consist of Ni, and upper part should consist of Ni plus plus, because this region will tell you that because of this factor, because of measurement limit, or the limit what we consider as the percentage of nickel ion in the solution that can be measured with our experimental data. So if I consider in this fashion, then it is very clear that the lower part should be nickel, the upper part should be Ni++. Now we have two regions now. The regions are this region is Ni plus plus, this region is Ni, and of course I have to specify that this line is for concentration Ni plus plus equal to 1. If I go down to 10 to the minus 6, this will also go down, fine. So now you see, for the first reaction what we have considered in the beginning, that can be put on this E versus pH diagram, and it's a horizontal line. So one part is over. Let me see second reaction. Second reaction was Ni plus 2H2O equal to Ni OH whole 2 plus 2H plus plus 2E. Sorry, I have to write it in a reverse manner. So this is, this part would be equal to Ni plus 2H2O, because I need to find out the reduction potential. So I can also calculate reduction potential for this process in standard state, because I know the value of mu 0 Ni OH whole 2, I know the value of mu 0 H2O, I know the value of mu 0 of Ni and mu 0 of H plus. This is also a process where electron accepting, electron is getting accepted, or reduction process is taking place. So I can put it in terms of E, which is, now let me write it in this manner, OH whole 2 H plus, or I can say ox red would be equal to E0 ox red plus RT. Here also I have two electron, so 2F into Ln, ox is this side, because this side is taking electron, so Ni OH whole 2, the concentration of Ni OH whole 2, concentration of H plus square, because 2 is involved, two number of hydrogen ions that are involved, and this is Ni concentration of H2O whole square. Now this is happening in pure medium, okay. Now, this is a solid which is precipitating out. What would be the concentration or activity? This would be 1. This is another pure metal. Here also I can consider it as 1. Now, this is also a pure H2O, which is concentration would also be 1. Now, if these are 1, so I can write E0OX by red plus, now I put all those values here, R, T and F at 25 degrees Celsius, then this would become 0.059 into, now instead of ln, ln I would write log H plus square. Now, if I take this square out, there would be a term two, because two is there. So now I can write it as E zero ox red. I can take a minus sign, and then I can put the minus sign here. 0.05922 would get cancelled, log of H plus. Let me take this out also. 0.059 minus of log of H plus. If you see this, what is this? This is nothing but pH of the solution. So, this would become E0OX red minus 0.059 pH. Now, this is EOX red. Now, this is my equation. Now, you see this equation has a relation between E0, that is the standard reduction potential for this reduction process, and pH of the solution. So, these also we can plot in E versus pH. And if you see that this is also a straight line equation, because this is a constant and this is the variable and that is nothing but the pH. So, I can plot this on E versus pH plot, and this should be having a negative slope which is nothing but minus 0.059. So, I can also plot it in green color. Let me plot. So, I can have, let me put it in this is nothing but E ox red equal to E 0 ox red minus 0.059 pH. This is my equation of that line, and this equation was E equal to E 0 plus 0.059 by 2 nickel plus plus. Let me stop here. I can continue in the next lecture.